Hello and welcome to a new video. My name is Tevik Juster and today we discuss the regulatory affairs for drinking water in relation to polymeric materials. Okay, let's get us started with a short introduction to regulatory affairs. So when we ignore regulatory affairs, this can lead to a recall of products. It can lead to financial damage for the affected company, a reputation damage, and in the worst case, investigation by the public prosecutor office. So this is what we want to avoid, because it's really the combination out of loss of financial reputation and court. So when we look now at the regulatory affairs for plastics, so polymers, when we have a plastic compound, we have a polymer resin and additives, and the polymer is by definition a macromolecule, so it's a big molecule which is not causing biological reactions. And as a consequence, polymers are not often the main focus of regulation, it's more the additives and also other, for example, solvents for the polycondensation. This is, for example, here, when we look at the solvents which are used for the polycondensation of PEEK or PPS, so we have in PEEK we have diphenylsulfone, which is regulated, and we have NMP for PPS. Okay, now let's have a look at the regulatory affairs for drinking water. Let's start in Europe, particularly in Germany, with the KTW guideline. So KTW stands for Kunststoffe im Trinkwasserkontakt. And this guideline is issued by the German Environmental Agency. So what is the content? So it's this guideline defines all hygienic requirements for organic materials which are in contact with drinking water. So the main aim is to ensure the hygienic harmlessness. And there's also the W270 test, which we discuss then in the next section. But in general, all these tests, the plastic needs to run through cold and warm water tests, migration tests, smelling and tasting tests, and then you get a certificate which is valid for 5 years. Okay, then why is it important? Yeah, it's relevant for all parts and materials which are in contact with drinking water. And a good advice is during material selection to already clarify and check if the selected material for this drinking water application is already tested according to KTW, because it's resulting often in long testing times, and so it's beneficial when the material has this already. Important is the KTW is not valid for plastic coatings or elastomers. Then, already previously mentioned, the W270, which is part of the DVGW, so it's also a regulation of Germany, and the DVGW stands for Deutscher Verein des Gas- und Wasserfaches. So now we not only cover water but also gas applications. So as it's written here, it's a platform to exchange technical information regarding gas and water supply. And why it is important? So we have this test W270, which is needed for the plastics which are in contact with drinking water, and for polyethylene drinking water pipes, so the PE80 and the PE100, there's the so-called W364. So what is the W270? It describes the development of microorganisms on materials which are used for drinking water. So we have to imagine we have a plastic part, and when it's in contact with drinking water, bacteria can attach to the surface, and these bacteria can start to grow, because as we all know, all life starts in water. And how does the test now look in detail? So we have a surface of 800 square centimeters, and this surface is for 3 months long in contact with running water. And then afterwards, estimation is done of the biomass which is formed on the surface. And as a result, we get then the biomaterial in milliliter per 800 square centimeter. What is the border? It's 0.07 milliliter per 800 square centimeter. Then when the material passes this test, you get then also again the certificate, which is valid for 5 years. Okay, now we jump into the United Kingdom, the so-called Water Regulations Advisory Scheme, the RAS. It's since 1999, and the RAS is an independent non-profit organization in the UK, and they define the standards for the drinking water, so the public water supply. Why it is important? So there we have the BS 6920, which is valid for all non-metal materials in contact with drinking water, and it's a similar test to the W270. So you have again testing plates. They are brought in contact with water, and then different tests are done. So you check the taste, optical quality, growth of microorganism, toxicity test of the extractable substances, and check also on metal ions. And if this is passed, you get the approval, RAS approved material with a registration number, and this is saved in a database, and it's again 5 years valid. And for England and Wales, there's the DWI, so the Drinking Water Inspectorate, and they have a separate water supply regulation. Okay, let's jump to the United States of America. There is the National Sanitation Foundation. It's founded in 1944, and it's also, in the meantime, an international independent non-profit organization. They published for the health system already over 75 standards. And most of these standards are also in line with the American National Standard Institute. And then you always have this double NSF, ANSI stamp on the certificates. So why it is important? There are different groups which are relevant for drinking water in contact with plastics. So there is the NSF 14, so which is for the plastics piping systems, then the NSF 61, so for the individual drinking water system components. And when we have also food contact, you have the NSF 51, so it's the food equipment materials, and the NSF 12 for example, the automatic ice making equipment. Okay, and then when we look now at the state of California, there's the Proposition 65, which is called the Safe Drinking Water and Toxic Enforcement Act of 1986. So it's a law of the US state of California. And the population wanted to know which substances can cause cancer or do other harm. So the government created a list of substances to indicate cancer or other harming. And if the product contains now such a substance, it needs to be labeled with a warning signal. And there are all over 800 compounds already listed. Why it is important? Because within these 800 compounds, some can be relevant or used for making plastics or are part of it. So when you think of heavy metal and chloride products, monomers such as isoprene and acrylates, then we have also decomposition products such as formaldehyde, and for all these substances and materials, are upper usage borders defined and combined with. Okay, let's continue with a summary of the regulatory affairs for plastics in the particular field of drinking water. So we have the KTW guideline, which is in particular for Germany, relevant for all parts and materials in contact with drinking water. Then we have also relevant for Germany, the DVGW or the W270 test. For the polyethylene pipes such as P80 and P100, there is the W364. Then we have in the United Kingdom the RAS with the test of BS6920, so non-metal materials in contact with drinking water. Then in the USA we have the NSF with the different sections like NSF 14, 61, 51 and 12. Dealing with drinking water, but not only, but also with food materials, food equipment materials. And then there is the Proposition 65 of the state of California, where the 800 compounds which can cause some harm or cancer and may be used for making plastics or, Okay, if you want to have more information on polymer engineering topics, I recommend to check out my blog findoutaboutplastics.com and also the particular field of material selection. I have two online courses, a general polymer material selection course and a polymer selection course for electric vehicles. And I will link you both, so the blog and the online courses, in the description below. Okay, with that we are at the end of this video. I would like to thank you for watching. Until next time, below here you can find the other parts to watch next. Bye.